Hey everybody, it's Charlie from Daily Motor. Welcome to the live drive of the 2022 Toyota GR86. We're excited to spend the next hour or so going around talking about what makes this a cool sports car here in 2022, and most importantly, taking it out for some drives and slides. And we know there are a lot of you in there, so let us know if you're in the chat. We're gonna do a little quick walk around and then start getting to your chats. Without any further ado, the 86. Brethren to the Subaru BRZ, technically designed and developed by Subaru, but this one with a little bit of Toyota's little flair on top. And I gotta say, I prefer the Toyota model over the Subaru. I think it looks just a little bit better. Plus, I'd rather be driving a Toyota than a Subaru. Sorry, WRX fanboys. I also really like the styling of this car versus its predecessors. The previous ones looked a little boy racery. This one smooths things out a little bit, makes it just a little bit more mature. I even see kind of echoes to fifth gen Viper in here. I know that's a bit of a stretch, but something soft, but yet firm and aggressive lines in the headlights. Big gaping grille, which is primarily functional, and good sports car proportions as well. A nice longer hood, and then kind of your cabin area. Big spoiler here on the premium model. Some fun wheels. It's just a good looking car. Not to mention this bright red paint really screams sports car. What do you think, Bliss?
I think it is very beautiful.
Everyone says, yeah. Say hello.
Hi. Wearing glasses because I forgot to order contacts. It's very beautiful. I really love the black and the red contrast.
Yeah.
I don't really see a whole lot of chrome on this, and I think that's beautiful.
Not a chromey type of car.
It's not a chromey type of car, no. It looks like an aggressive, sporty, fast bug. Actually, when you first pulled into our driveway with it, I was like, wait, you got a Porsche? And I did only get a glance of it, definitely from like this side back.
Yeah, it can kind of look like a Cayman at brief appearance, especially in Guards Red. Yeah, I could see that.
It was really pretty.
Really
gorgeous. Ooh, I really like how the spoiler is so swoopy. It's like a brush stroke. If you really get it from this angle, that is pretty.
Fun fact, this larger spoiler is just a taped-on option from the dealer. In the premium model, there's a smaller spoiler below this that's actually functional, so you could technically just like yank that off. Yeah, but I really like the rear of this car. I even like how the gas cap is like not circular, it's sort of formed into the car.
Yeah,
and I love the tail lights, I love the little GR86 badge. Yeah,
it's really good.
I agree. Who do we got in the comments? Let's buzz through what we got going so far.
We've got Sunjid Ramen.
Hello.
OR3NG4 says good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Say hello to Joey Finley.
Hey, Joey.
Mukisa, most wanted.
Nice, nice.
Alrighty. False is in the chat.
Hello, False.
Hello.
Wonder when we're going to get Hank the Nice Man in again.
No, where is he at?
Yeah.
Sears says hello, everyone.
Okay.
That's Yas.
Hello, Yas.
Yeah.
Mr. Yas now.
Thimio Scrimpass. And I think I mentioned Mukisa already. They both say hi. These are Pilot Sport 4S's.
No, they don't put grippy tire. Oh, wait, they are. Wait, no, they're just Pilot Sport 4s, not 4S's.
Maybe he meant 4s?
Yeah, maybe he did. I thought they put Primacies on here, but I must be mistaken. A fun fact, back when this model first came out in the earlier 20-teens, they put Prius tires on this car because they wanted it to not be too grippy. They wanted it to be fun and you to be able to slide it around. So
that's cool. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Actually, Cryptonix said, I think they are Pilot Sport 4, but not S.
There you go. Good job, Cryptonix. Yeah.
Pittsburgh Man says hello.
Hey, Pitty's making it in. Pittsburgh, how did your date go last week?
Yeah.
Did you get her flowers?
Spill.
Yeah, we want to hear the tea.
Oh, God. And Cryptonix says, this is the best car I've ever driven.
Wow.
My friend has one and it's so fun to rip on. I love how notchy the transmission is.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that a little bit in the drive today because it's a tough car to drive smooth. It's definitely not as refined and easy from the clutch and shifter action and even the steering as a lot of other cars. So we're going to talk about that and a little update on our donation amounts. Oh, there goes Chris in the beautiful Macan S, which we are not live driving tonight. Although that would have been a lot of fun to, gosh, look at that thing when it's in the sunlight. It just looks so good. We are getting that one tomorrow for a brief little bit of time.
Cool. Did you do a poll?
I did a poll. It was between this and the Nissan Rogue that we have this week, and this was overwhelming. This will be more fun than the Macan. Macan would have been pretty, but this will be a better choice. What was I saying? Oh yeah, donation amounts. For every $5 in donation we get, we will do a launch. For $20 total, we'll do a little burnout. And if we reach $50 total in donations, we'll put Alissa behind the wheel. And I should remind everyone that Cash App donations are double. So if we were to get 25 on the Cash App, we'll see what Alissa can do. She hasn't driven a stick since probably
last year.
The Miata or the Cayman that we had last year.
There was a nine.
Porsche Cayman.
Okay.
Yep.
A little sporty one.
Mm-hmm. Yes. All right. I'm going to pop the hood and we'll get to a few more comments. Take a look at this 2.4 liter boxer 4 motor, not an inline 4. That's what makes this car a little bit more charismatic than some of the others.
I should take this first.
There it is. So boxer motors are flat. Instead of the pistons coming up this way or in a V coming out in a V shape, they're flat way down low. So that makes a lower center of gravity and a little bit different character. But you can see right here, it does say Subaru on it. Toyota and Subaru, even though really we know Subaru did the heavy lifting on this engine.
That's cool.
Yep. Kind of neat how the red is darker inside the car. It's like a more lipstick red.
Yeah, look at the difference.
It's not polished up, shiny.
Right. Neat.
Okay.
Cool.
Shall we have Alissa do the back seat test? If you want to come over to this side.
Yeah, I'll come over to that.
My bag's over there. Back seats are not unusable in this car, but they are tight. Ooh, some bikes having fun out there. Some buckets back there.
Wow. There's nowhere for my legs to go.
There we go.
It sucks.
No frunk in this car for the Alissa frunk test. All right. Headroom? Passing?
Yeah. Headroom.
Now my head hits in this car, but Alyssa's does not.
I'm awesome.
And.
Ah. Wow.
What do you think?
So the top of my feet are hitting the very bottom, living in the bottom. Okay, so Charlie's raising the chair. That's better. That's actually a lot better. Yeah, can this go, do you want this to go back more? Because I've got some room.
Let me see how I could
squish.
Drive.
Actually, that's fine.
I could drive like this.
That's fine, yeah, I'm okay. My knees are hitting, but actually, right where your knees would be, there's
they do a little cutout.
There's like it's a cutout, and then they just put the seat cover over it. So there's like a lot of space where my knees actually can go in.
Cool.
Yeah, cool. I could do this.
5'1", passable in the back of the GR86.
Yeah. It's interesting that like it's just bench. I guess I expected like two seats. But that makes sense, like, because that would also save space.
Sure.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, I could do that. Neat. I don't know if anyone.
Yeah, it'd be tougher for me to do it. That's for sure.
Do you want to try it?
I can try it. Getting out is not exactly graceful, but.
No.
There you go. Yeah. So for me. My head hits, so I have to kind of sit to the side, and then bringing this back. Now the seat's scooted forward as well, but it's less of a legroom issue for me and definitely more of a headroom issue. Rough, so somewhere between 5'1 and 5'10 is the magic number.
Maybe a 5'5 is like the limit.
Yeah, but if you wanted to throw your kids back there or something, you certainly could, or if you just needed to bring someone home after a night at the bar or something like that.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Do a quick peek at the trunk and then we'll get in the car.
All right.
The trunk is actually fairly usable in the 86.
Okay.
Yeah, better than a Miata.
You could do maybe set of golf clubs in there.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you can fold the seats so things really stretch out. However, Chris Amos did say that the opening in this one is smaller than his previous Gen BRZ, so that does limit you a bit.
Interesting.
Yep.
Cool.
All right. Actually, you want to do a startup clip real quick?
Yeah.
Most aggressive?
No, subtle.
Yeah. Yeah, this car is a very good exercise in giving you what you need and not really much more in terms of being a sports car. Its main purpose is to be a sports car.
Okay.
Not to be a luxury car or anything like that. Yeah. All right, comments?
Yes, so many.
I bet. Alissa does a really good job at skimming.
William Long's in the chat.
Hey, William.
Says, finally get to catch a live drive again. Good.
Nice.
Pittsburgh Man has an update on his date.
Ooh.
Went to get sushi and calamari. But Mari did not get her flowers, got her chicken wings to take home, though. Sometimes that's better than flowers.
Yeah, that can definitely hit.
Yeah.
Nice. Glad to hear that, Pittsburgh Man.
Thymios is asking if this is an automatic or a manual.
Here's your answer.
It's a manual. Sanjib is asking for a 22 Porsche Macan S.
Well, funny you ask, considering we have a 22 Porsche Macan S.
Yeah, very cool. Also, Pittsburgh Man says they went to the beach. They went to a beach hippie type festival on Sunday. Oh, and they've been dating for almost 3 years.
Oh.
Crooked neck Charles. Cryptonix, who I believe said this was the best car that they've ever driven,
yes,
said, I'm 6'1", and not too used to a two-door coupe, so I kept smacking my head on the roof while getting out.
Yeah.
I have that problem, too.
That's totally understandable. Gotta beat the traffic coming on here.
Very loud.
Well, it's a little bit harder to drive these one-handed.
Let me grab this.
No, that loudness is a big source of contention for me with this car, and we'll talk about that after we get through this round of comments.
Lots of traffic to wait for.
Are we caught up?
No.
Oh, no, after we get through this round of comments.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so do you have that problem? When do you keep hitting your head against the roof?
Okay.
Yeah, he's just got a little bit of space right there. Okay, cool. Yas says the back seat is like a third row of the Model Y.
Ha. Yeah, that makes sense.
Nice to have a back seat like that, though, for insurance reasons.
Yeah, if that does make a big difference.
Yep. Joey is sending a donation via Cash App.
Ooh, thank you, Joey.
Thank you for notifying us through this. You are right, the notifications don't always come through on the phone.
Check that when it is safe.
Yep. Two-handed driving. Chandler Horning is in the chat.
Thank you, Joey. We got the $20 donation from Joey.
Nice. Okay.
Hey, Chandler. Glad to have you in. Congrats on your new gig.
Oh, very cool.
Mm-hmm. He's moving to Atlanta, Georgia.
Oh, very nice.
Mm-hmm.
I hear that's a fun city. He says, I remember barely fitting in the back seat of a 2014 Mustang, but the most recent generation is a no-go for me.
Wow.
Says also, careful, don't suck all that RTV up the oil pickup.
Oh, yeah, I guess that must be an issue I'm not familiar with.
Interesting, yeah. Pittsburgh Man says, Joey Moneybag Finley.
Ha. Mm. Yeah, we'll have to do a little smoky smokes for Joey.
Right. Smokes for Joe. Man says Charlie's only 5'10 like us peasants. We don't have 6'1 problems.
Joey out of the way right now while I think about it.
Okay.
What does the sign say? Oh, probably now hiring.
Yep.
Anyone want to be a truck driver?
Nope. I don't. Although you wouldn't have people messing with you.
Engine to rev, so I do find myself accidentally blipping the throttle too much and still kind of having some unsmooth. The car that does take the one and on the wind from the direction.
Chandler says a friend of mine and many others are finding extra RTV clogging the oil pickup and starving the engine for oils, resulting in engine failure sometimes.
That is unfortunate.
Yeah, that's really unfortunate. That would be a problem for long-term owners.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, says, dang, does it have long gear ratios or is it just buzzy?
A little bit of both. So what I wanted to talk about earlier is it pipes in a lot of fake noise. And it doesn't sound good. It's very loud.
That's fake?
Yeah, oh yeah. Most of that is fake. The... A lot of that is fake. I mean, there's real noise too, but it pipes in extra. So the Topher, when he bought his, disconnected that speaker within the first, like before he even drove it off the dealer lot. And yeah, I don't understand why Toyota and Subaru doesn't make that toggleable. So you can turn it on and off.
Interesting.
But yeah, I do not enjoy the sound of it.
Toggleable. Interesting. Very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
QQQQ thinks we paid money for this car and is asking if we paid MSRP.
Oh, yes, we did not actually purchase this car. This is a press vehicle from Toyota and therefore we did not pay anything.
Yes.
Thanks,
but
Toyota.
For those of you that are wondering, MSRP for this is about 32 grand.
Yep. Specifically, $32,432.
Yes.
And this is a premium model.
Neat.
Yes.
Premium being an extra $2,500? Because base is like 33,
30. I think this base would be lower if it weren't a premium.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yep, it'd be like 27.
Cool.
And it's built in Japan.
Right. That's very neat. Pittsburgh Man says this car would be a fun project build car. Only for summer driving, though. I'm convinced the snow here would be higher than the hood.
Yeah, ground clearance would be a holdup for winter. But, like, I know that the Topher drives his year-round and just tosses some winter tires on it and sends it. But, yes, if you have a lot, like, high snow, then that would be an issue.
Yeah. Probably where he is in Canada.
Right.
Yep. Cool. Ford guys would like an exhaust clip. He must have missed the one earlier.
Okay, we'll try to remember to do another one.
Sanjay would like to know what the video for tomorrow is.
Tomorrow we have two videos going live. One is the infotainment review on the pre-refresh 330i BMW. I drive 7 in that one. And then the second video going up on Daily Motor is a little snippet clip on how Super Cruise works in the Silverado.
Very cool.
Mm-hmm.
That's quite nice.
Yep.
Miran is in the chat. He says, sorry I'm late.
Hey, Miran. No worries.
Glad to have you.
Miran, what are your thoughts on the 86?
Yeah. Mario says, thanks for answering his question earlier about the heel to toe.
You're welcome.
And Pittsburgh Man would like to know what the premium extras are. We just put that away. Let's see if you can remember.
It's the Alcantara seats, which we have here. They're very nice and soft. And the 8-speaker sound system over the 6-speaker. Little duck wing spoiler attachment. Doesn't have navigation. I'm trying to... Probably automatic climate control. Dual zone quiet climate controls probably, and probably the heated seats as well. Mm. Yeah, I think that's the most of it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. William Long is asking if you would prefer this or an ND Miata. Before, he's got stipulations. One, as an only car, and then two, as a second car. Great question.
I would pick the Miata. I like convertibles. And I prefer the powertrain in the Miata. It's easier to drive smoothly. It's softer. It takes itself a little bit less seriously. This feels a little more harsh. Also, the fake noise. I mean, obviously, you can change that super easily. And I don't like Subarus. And I like Mazdas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. In fact, before we even started this live drive back at home, mm-hmm. Charlie was like, I think I'd still pick a Miata.
Yeah, it was hard for me to decide, but I think if I were forced to make the decision right now, I'd say Miata. It'd be a shame, because then once we have kids, this would make more sense to be able to put the kids in the rear, but, you know, it's...
Yeah.
I'm assuming if it's my only car, that means that Alissa has left me for some reason, and then I won't have children.
Won't have kids. Yeah. Unless you find someone else.
Maybe Alyssa's cat had gotten run over, and therefore she offed herself. Which was also a hypothetical we were discussing before the live drive.
Yeah, I like my cats. Yeah. We'll just get a Camaro for the children.
There you go. There's a big cloud rolling in. It's going to make for good lighting in here.
Yeah.
What if it rains? Then we can really slip inside.
That'll
this
be
thing.
Fun. Okay, cool. All right. Ooh, Ford guy says, don't cut the roof off the town and country, then you'll be forced to send it to the crusher after you're done. And I appreciate that comment, Ford guys, because I agree.
Ford guys, I have a big garage that I can just park it in permanently, so it could become literally just a hangout place in the garage and then drive it around when we want.
Copper says, the fact that there were more people in the live drive for an electric Chevy crossover than this speaks to the Daily Motor audience.
Yeah, every now and then, Chris Brower is like, hey, can we get this, like, super awesome BMW performance sedan? And I'm like...
They don't make money.
Yeah, I'm like, more people are going to watch a video on a Civic, yeah. So...
Pittsburgh Man agrees and says, electric crossovers are the future.
Yeah.
And yeah, they definitely are.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. All right. Couple more. Jasuur says, as much as I like manuals, I think I'd rather have an all-electric GR86.
Ooh, that would be pretty cool.
That'd be really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yusuf Jasuur became a DM supporter.
Oh, hey, thanks, man.
Yeah,
appreciate
very
that.
Cool. Glad to have you. Why? I'm sure that was so entertaining for everyone. Do you want to drive and not do comments anymore, or do you want me to do comments still?
You can still do comments.
Okay. Jeez! Ford Guys is asking if you would ever get a Mazda MX-5 or a soft top for a 22.
Probably the soft top. The RF is really good, don't get me wrong, but I'm a softie.
Gotcha.
I do think the RF looks sweet, though.
Why did that turn dark? Pittsburgh Man says, speaking of kids, we need a shoe check, Charles.
Ha!
I don't know what that means.
No New Balances yet, Pittsburgh Man.
Oh,
just my deteriorating Target shoes.
We've only been married for like 3 months.
Hey, man. That's long enough for some. That's long enough for Kirk Kreifels.
It's not long enough for some, actually, because they do it before.
Hmm.
Anyways, how do you see the future of sports cards going?
I guess motors will be around for a while for sports cars.
Cool.
But someone will come out with an electric-y sports car too, that'll be cool. Just, they need to try to keep them light. Light and fun to drive. I think Audi will be the first to bring a good one in.
Ooh, cool.
Yeah.
That would be really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Jasuur says, I agree, I prefer a Miata over a BRZ GR86 too.
Ooh, that is a Genesis Coupe.
Coupe.
Hmm. Got him?
No.
Oh.
You can drive along.
I want to do the burnout.
Oh. Well, let's do that, and then we'll do comments.
Okay.
We'll do catch up on some more.
Alright.
We've been talking for a while. A live drive, not a live sit.
Now, when we tried to do the burnout on the Bolt, it didn't go super well, but this one should be much better.
Look at the sunshine coming in through some of the clouds. It's pretty.
this and this.
Oh, I'm gonna cut. That's why you wanted me to shut up. I kid. Scared me so much. I just predict
chaos.
For sure. I don't know.
Like this.
Oof.
Smoky.
Very.
Surprised I didn't make more smoke from the burnout. Probably smoke.
The S in sport stands for smoke, and these are only fours.
They're only fours. Response to the engine. And if you so much on this rally and turn, the back end coming around is a very fun way to drive. Just kinda, you can feel just a little bit of shuffle. Transmission feels really good as well, as a nice touch to it. Probably very comparable in enjoyment to the Miata, maybe not comparable in feel.
Interesting.
Yeah. We're gonna get stuck on a journey.
It's not a journey.
In front of us.
No, I'm saying it's not a journey if we're getting stuck behind one.
There you go.
Just over your head, Charles.
$50 total, we will put Alissa behind the wheel for her first time driving manual in a long time.
In like a year.
Yep.
It won't be fun because I'm going to be like, how do I do this again? And it'll be very slow and I'll drive for like 5 minutes and like, that's it.
So you can tell she doesn't want you guys to get into that donation mode. So we'll leave it up to you.
Yeah. Charlie's the one that can drive it fast and squealy and make the end turn out.
This.
Yeah.
Yeah, once you start kind of getting familiar with how to make this car dance, it really does reward just a nice slide. And I can see why the Topher likes it so much, because it's so satisfying, like that drift right there to just get that.
Yeah.
It's so low stakes. Look at all the birds!
Oh my god!
Look at all the birds! They don't care either. They're just like, no, we're vibing.
They're like, we'd rather die.
Somebody killed their cat.
Poor guy says if... I'll wait. Hit some broken pavement. Sent it.
Yeah.
Neat. Poor guy says if Peggy really is that rusty, you should just cut the roof off.
There you go, my man.
Yeah, it really is.
That's what I'm saying.
Miran says GT86 is excellent, but I would choose the ND Miata. just for the engine's potential alone. You can make over 600
wheel
horsepower in stock block.
Wow, that's crazy. Miran, if you build us a 600 wheel Miata, that would be incredible, and I will drive out there and pick that up after I pick up the 300cc Grom. Also, fun fact, when we go out to California, we're going to drive Miran's cool cars, or at least check them out.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome. I love that.
We have a little sub collab.
I want to meet Miran.
Yeah.
Sounds like a cool guy. Bird guy, is a manual.
You bet. Bet your butt.
Cars and Crows says, how would you compare the handling of this with the 22 Civic Si? Is the practicality of the Si worth the performance deficit versus the GR86 if you occasionally need four doors?
I say yes. The Civic is an incredibly practical, useful, efficient, smooth, enjoyable car. This is a sports car. It's an affordable sports car, but the Civic makes for a much, much better daily. That being said, I'd want to put some sort of tune on the Civic to eliminate the rev hang. This doesn't really have any annoying rev hang. The engine is very responsive. The Civic, not. And, I mean, yeah, rear-wheel drive is more fun from just a hoonigan standpoint, but realistically, when you're just commuting and driving around, it should be hanging rear end. Probably.
Cryptonix says, ha ha ha.
That's a probably like $500.
Well, do I have to like make it go fast and stuff, or is it just like a tire burnout?
Tire burnout.
Probably whatever it would cost to fix the engine.
Stout. Oh, this is a Subaru, so.
Oh, Joey's gotta leave.
Glad to have you in, Joey. Don't know. Always appreciate you.
Thanks. Automotive says LMAO at the DRL shutting off when the handbrake pulled.
Look at this.
Oh, look at that. What is this?
It's a Supra.
Oh, a Supra.
A license plate Supra.
Do you know what we are? Hello.
What a tool.
That's funny. Okay, cool. I'm catching up on stuff. How is the sound system?
You know, I haven't listened to it too much yet. I was going to do the test today, but then I got a nail on the tire, so I wasn't
yeah.
able to do that.
So. You kind of ruined your day.
I remember the bass system's not that good. This one's probably only like a C, maybe a B if it's lucky. Probably a C.
Very cool. Okay. I mean, kind of cool. Yacht says he donated via the Cash App.
Oh, snap. Oh, boy. You driving this.
Damn it.
Thank you, Yas. Appreciate you.
All right, cool. Thank you, Yas. He did ask. Or, oh, for how much for me to do a burnout. You driving this.
Super's gonna race us.
Oh, bye. Sanjib is interested in a video on the Toyota Highlander Platinum.
Highlander Plat? Alright, yeah, we'll probably get one at some point.
Cool. You got it, Sanjib. Pittsburgh Man says, crying laughing faces, Miran the residential, make me this car, but faster, please.
Yeah, seriously.
William says, I hope some version of this general automotive premise lives on in the future.
Yeah, cheap, fun, sporty car.
Yeah, evolve it carefully, don't revolutionize. I'd be curious what this would be like if it had some sort of hybrid system.
Actually, I was going to have you start here, but then I realized in order to get out on the street, you'd have to do,
I'd rather not get out on the street.
Yeah.
If you don't mind.
Well, you can do over by the test loop where there's, like, not really any traffic.
I actually would really rather not.
go out on the street at all.
Even just the casual.
Yeah. I haven't driven it. I haven't driven in a really long time.
Okay.
Maybe afterwards I'll be like, oh.
You gotta say that to us, not to me.
Well, you're the one that put it as an option. You never consulted me.
I did, like yesterday. I said you can drive, and you were like, mm-hmm. Would you rather drive in here or back at the airport?
Oh, yeah, the airport. Yeah, back at the airport. We'll get there quick.
Hopefully, there's no 5-0 looking for the people who were slipping and sliding around.
Yeah. I haven't seen any coppers there lately.
No wood to knock on here. None of my touch-sensitive wood. The IX had.
Okay, Charles. Pittsburgh Man says, fun fact, neither of you are driving a Toyota.
Yeah, we're really just driving a Subaru.
Yeah.
And the other guy was driving a BMW. That guy's super.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, actually, that's what William Long said. You mean that's a BMW? Ford Guys has a great video idea.
Okay.
He's asking if you could do a video on how to drive a stick, since people are interested in learning.
Yeah, I could probably do that someday. I feel like that's like the generic like video that every car YouTuber does at some point. So I'll have to try to figure out some way to make it interesting, like use some real janky old car, or like do it with a pogo stick or something.
Oh my gosh.
Or like just have some extra premise, like, I don't know, maybe one of Miran's GT350s that are like twin turbo and have like 1,000 horsepower, take Alissa out there and have her like practice with one of those and be like, this is how you drive a stick.
Yeah. We could get like a really easy car for me to drive, like a Miata, which is something that we had, and then just do like, I don't know, 30-minute video on me driving it.
Yeah, but like teaching my woman how to drive stick is like, again, like the most cliche automotive YouTuber video that is.
Okay, fine. Fine. We could just get divorced so I'm not your woman.
Perhaps. Even Doug DeMuro had like teaching a girl how to drive stick in his Viper.
Huh. Yeah. Neat. Says getting my Trek BRED 86 ceramic coated.
Oh, track, maybe track red, that's the color of this.
Yeah, yeah. Track red, whatever. You're welcome. The GR Corolla.
I don't know, man. That's too hard to say because the engine can make or break the Corolla. I know the Civic is going to be good, but will the Corolla be good? And will the suspension be too harsh? So if the suspension is compliant and the engine is fantastic, then I would probably pick the Toyota. But all of my heart goes toward Honda. So.
All of my heart?
Yep.
That's so cute. Cool. Okay, so this, or the Hyundai Veloster, and both as manuals.
Veloster.
Yeah, I knew you were going to say that one.
Yeah.
Veloster's really cool.
Veloster's really cool. Veloster feels... Oh, shit, that is the cops.
Alright, we'll have to turn around.
Wasn't me, sir.
I'm just going to hide the GoPro down a little bit so he doesn't think it's something weird. I swear we're not breaking the law.
They're gonna be like, hey, we got reports of a red sports car making a whole bunch of noise. We're gonna be like, must have been someone else, sir.
Too bad this doesn't have like an eco mode on it or something. Oh, he's cleaning his car.
Oh, good.
He's cleaning it.
Good. Well, Liz, I think you're gonna practice stick over by the garage.
All right, man. Well, we came over here for nothing.
Yep.
Cryptonix is asking, Veloster N or the Elantra N?
I'd pick the Veloster, even though the Elantra is better in most ways.
Yeah, I really like how the Veloster looks.
Right.
Yeah.
And you can call it Veloster.
Veloster. No, I can't say that. I almost bought a Veloster.
By almost bought, you mean you test drove one and you were like, this feels like crap.
Yeah.
But it was a first gen Veloster.
Yeah, it was a first gen one. It was like a 2013 and it was red. And it felt janky when I drove it. And then I drove a 2013 Passat and was like, oh, I want to buy this one. And they were the same price.
Nice. See, I'm predicting you're going to drive this. This is some cool and fun. Like, yeah.
I predict I'm going to be scared. That's okay. Comments, but they're bouncing all over.
Yeah.
Shift your toes while pushing the pedals with your hands to really stand out.
Yeah, he was talking about me. I could do how to drive.
Look at this super angry Jeep. They've got their dog on, like, the Sunjip wants you to do a drag race.
With the cop?
With the cop. That's
right. I do love it. It's just, with the Veloster, they focused on a fun car rather than like a serious sports car. And you could, it's obnoxious in a different way. Mostly the noise.
Mateus says, fun fact. Here in Brazil, our Hyundai Veloster is equipped with 120 horsepower 1.6 engine. We call it the Lerdaster, which Lerdo means very slow.
But probably not the N, because we had a slow Veloster too, but it just wasn't the N model.
Got it. Ford guys would like you to turn traction control off and spin the tires while driving.
We've been doing that.
It's been happening and you didn't know. Repair Guru New York says, if it comes to getting the BRZ for MSRP versus the GR86 for a 5K markup, which is better?
Yeah, you gotta just get the Subaru at that point.
Oh, he concedes.
I mean, that's what the Topher did, is he wanted the Toyota too, but he just had to buy what he could find, and that was a Subaru.
Fair.
So if you do end up wanting to come out, you can come out and go down that road.
Then, okay. Makes sense. Ford guys is having the same reaction to when they found it and I drove a 13
song. What happened was they sent a photo of it and he's diesel. And then I saw it, oh, she's a cheater. I said no. Oh, okay.
Yeah. But it was just an automatic.
It's a 5-cylinder though, so it sounded cool.
It sounded great. It was a great car. I miss that car daily. Yeah, automatic, not a diesel. Here you go.
All right. Do a little walk around and let Alissa get comfortable. We haven't done a walk around in a while. This is the bright red Toyota GR86. Such a cool looking car. I like the front, I like the back. There's really not an angle I don't like on it. Definitely like that angle. Looking good. I really like the tail lights. Very nice, very nice. All right, let's see how Alissa fits.
It's too bad you have to sit next to me because you'd have so much room behind me.
Yeah, you're right. She loves having to crank seats up.
Oh, I forgot to count. That's okay.
That's not a very large car, so in theory, she should be able to fit pretty well. She She tries to sit as far away from the wheel as possible so she doesn't get face blasted by the airbag. Be able to push the clutch all the way in. Okay. All right. Now we probably won't get to a ton of comments while we're doing this because I'll have to be paying attention.
Did it turn on?
So go ahead and before you start the engine up, just push the clutch in and get a feel for the shifter. Now you're in second.
Oh, get a feel for the shifter?
Yep. So that's the middle. And there's first.
That's first.
Second.
Third. One more time. And then I want to try going in reverse. Can I not go in reverse yet?
To go in reverse, you have to pull up the collar, and then you can go. It keeps you from accidentally doing it.
Smart.
Yep.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I pressed this. I didn't hear it start.
Because you have to push your clutch in.
And the gas?
Yep. No.
And the brake?
Nope, just the clutch.
I did the brake.
Gotcha.
This is still two.
Quick comments. It's been a while since I watched your live streams. How's the manual? The manual's pretty good. Alyssa's about to get her experience with it, but it's a nice feel. The clutch is a little tough to feel the bite sometimes. Pittsburgh Man says, let's go, Alyssa. And don't forget race mode.
Clutch in to put this down?
No, but you should have your foot on the brake if you're gonna do that. Just in case it doesn't roll anywhere. Yep. And then you'll just clutch in, first gear, and then a nice easy letting out.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Just remember you're never shifting gear without the clutch in.
Yeah.
And anytime something weird's happening, just clutch back in, come to a stop.
Clutch coming out. I hate this part of driving.
It's okay, you just gotta give it a little bit of gas too to kind of help it along. This engine does not have a torque, so.
I don't know what that means.
Like a strong engine, so some gas.
So,
it is. Yes. But you stall.
Okay.
Yep, so start it back up.
Do I need to go out and then go back in?
Nope. You just have to give the gas a few little blips to kind of get a feel for how it responds. Almost. So probably want to turn your wheel so that as you get going, you're not going to go into the curb.
Oh, there's still.
Ha. Nice and slow on the clutch. The car will start to grab. Let's double check. Push the clutch in. Stop. Make sure you're in first and not third. Over and up. Okay, it's possible you were in third, which would have been setting you up for disaster.
I like it when manual cars actually say what gear you're in.
It'll tell you, but only once you get going. I know, it's kind of silly. Yeah, there you go.
Oh my god.
You might have been in third last time, so.
Okay.
And there you are.
I hate it.
Thanks, I hate it.
I don't like driving manual at all.
Most Wanted said, go Alyssa. I had to step away for a few minutes, and this is a nice surprise to come back to.
Okay, cool.
And Yas said, send it. Pittsburgh Man said, Lissa, Lissa.
Aw, that's so sweet. You guys are all so very nice.
I would say you could drive to the back of the complex, but I don't know how our signal would do.
That's fair. And what do I do from here?
Well, if you want to come to a stop, you just clutch in and bring it into neutral and come to a stop. If you want to go out to that other road, to that side road, you could go out to the stop sign, and but I would come to a stop and try
I'm
doing
gonna,
first
I'm
again.
I'm gonna come to a stop.
Kisa said, yeah, and everyone said, woo!
Clutching. Just brake.
Clutching, yep.
Yep, clutches in.
Yep.
Neutral.
Very nice.
Cool. Okay.
All right.
Do it again. All right. Steering wheel is nice.
Isn't it nice?
Yeah. I'm gonna clutch in and then.
This douchebag parks there like for half an hour every, pretty much every night. I don't know why.
Dang it.
That's okay. Just right when you start to feel that bite, that's when you hand
it.
Just let the clutch out too fast. It'll just be a nice, gentle handoff between the one and the two.
The clutch is so much longer.
It's a tough clutch, too. Brower and I don't like it.
Yeah, it's... this is the thing for manuals. The clutch goes so far. And, like, mm-hmm. you're only ever using this much of your gas pedal.
Yeah.
And so it's like, when do I do it? When do I do it? Now! It's like, jeez.
Every manual's different.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's why even veterans will stall new cars sometimes, because it's like...
You gotta find it.
Yeah.
Alright, common... I'm only at 50% with the clutch.
Gas. There you go. Yep.
Sucks.
Fun fact, our buddy Stu, who's about to drive by over there, races autocross with one of these.
That sucks.
It's a good car for racing. Probably in neutral.
Oh. I'm gonna have to go. Hold on, let me complete this turn.
That's probably fourth. Clutch in. Okay.
Oh, here he comes.
That was fourth.
Oh, jeez. All right, well.
Good job, Liz.
Before I break this vehicle.
Stop. I'm doing a great job. It's a good car to learn on.
It's a tough manual to drive.
Is it?
The clutch is a little weird.
Yeah. The Fiat will be the car.
Yeah,
okay.
Let's go grab that.
Contour even is really good.
She's,
initial car.
She's done
I've done a Miata.
Yeah, you've done a Miata and a Cayman.
Drive this thing real quick.
Yeah, Stu, you race one of these, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tomorrow.
Nice.
5 days. Can't wait.
Where?
Nice.
Going to Osco.
Ooh.
Bavarian Inn. I'll do a shout out. Bavarian Inn in Oscoda. Amazing pastries, amazing breakfast, great family owned business. Check it out.
Okay.
Right.
What are you guys off to? Picking something up?
Nice. I can't get this week, but I'm going to take it.
Cool.
A friend of mine's buying it. Even better.
Alright, have fun.
Take it easy. Enjoy.
Would you like to read all of your congratulatory comments?
Because it'll make me feel better, because I feel like crap right
now. Yeah, you can from Moswana. Do a little walk around, and then we'll wrap this up.
Oh, I remember that. Alissa, that's cute.
So there you are, the 2022 Toyota GR86. Fun car to drive. Not the smoothest or most finessed, but a lot of times that's what people are going for. They want a raw experience. And here in 2022, I'm glad that people, there's a car out there still that does provide a raw experience and at a relatively affordable price point. I mean, you're not having to shell out a second mortgage just to get into one of these, and it's nice. Mm-hmm. Everyone say good job to Alissa.
Thank you. Sorry, I was so like, meh, but it's been a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's tough to go out in front
it
of
really
26
yeah.
people on the internet. Ruthless, ruthless savages out there.
You guys are very kind. Thank you so much for the donations. I'll try to do more manual practice in the future so that when you do pay money to see me drive, it's actually worth it.
Right.
So sorry.
Something tells me it's more worth it to get that than perfect execution.
Very sweet.
Yep. We just need to get a PT Cruiser manual convertible turbo, and then and then Alissa can drive manual all the time.
Or Bug.
Or Beetle. Yeah. Beetle would work too. All right, you want to catch me up on the last non-just saying your name comments so that we can wrap?
It's all about me, actually.
Yeah? It's just all about you.
Yeah. Did you read anything about, did you read Miran?
I did read Miran's, yeah.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah. How was the manual transition? Oh, yeah. Okay. That one.
Yeah, the big hard and clutch. Yep.
Yep.
Cool. Well, thanks, guys. Let me grab my phone real quick. I'll see what we've got coming next week, since y'all are always curious.
I wonder what you guys think of this massive grill. Typically, grills are not enjoyed, but...
You know what I say? Better a massive grill than a massive girl.
Wow.
That's why I got you.
Hey. Merkman.
Merkman?
I just custom ordered a 22 C300 4MATIC. And I was wondering if you think the digital lightning package was worth the extra, and do you think I should ceramic coat the manufacturer selenite gray magno?
I wouldn't do the ceramic coating unless you plan on keeping it for over 5 years. And in terms of lighting, I always think it's better to do to pay more for good lighting.
Neat.
Next week, we will have... Ooh. It's going to be tough, because we have a BMW i4 eDrive 40.
Okay.
And an Audi RS3.
Oh.
We'll probably do the RS3.
Wait, no, you'll do a poll.
I will do a poll, you're right. I hope you all appreciated the poll this time. A little ahead of the game, letting us get that. We also might have an Elantra N too, so I don't know. There's going to be a lot of fun cars. I'll put out a poll. Either way, the next month or so at Daily Motor are really exciting. I mean, we're talking Bronco Raptor, Ford Lightning, RS3, Macan, and all culminating with 911 GT3.
Holy smokes.
I'm excited. I hope you all are too. Are there any last comments I should get to?
Ford guy thinks I should buy a TDI Volkswagen Beetle stick shift.
Oh, yeah. That's convertible, too.
Convertible. Yeah. Yep. Anything a TDI would be cool.
Mm-hmm.
But that's a diesel one.
Yep.
Yeah. Cool. Stranger danger. Thank you guys so much. Pittsburgh Man votes RS3.
Okay. Most people probably will.
Most wanted says i4, if it weren't for the RS3.
Exactly. Yeah, so. It's almost a shame. Maybe we'll try to do both. I don't know.
That could be cool. A twofer. Yep. All right, cool. We're all set.
Thanks, everyone, for watching. And we'll see you on the next one. We're Charlie and Alissa from Daily Motor. And as always, drive on.